In this presentation, we're going to look at this simple three-span bridge. We've got spans of 31.5, 35, 31.5. The deck's 10 meters wide. We've got two deep ribs and the deck slab is 0.3 thick. So inside LUSAS, we're going to start a new model. I'm just going to call this simple PT bridge. We're going to use the analysis category 3D. I'm going to work in kilonewton meters. Okay, now for this particular model, we're going to import the geometry from CAD. So it's this layout that I'm going to bring in. Okay, so these are the lines I've just imported. Now, I'm just going to look end on to the model and just resize that. Now I'm going to box select these lines. Now these are the lines that are going to represent the deep rib. I'm going to look at the end, select the surfaces. These are the surfaces that are going to represent the slab. And these lines here, I'm going to use for the slicing utility later. Now I don't need to see these at the moment, so I'm going to make a group of them. Just call these slice lines. And I'm going to make that group invisible. Okay, so I can now start putting the engineering properties onto this. So attributes, mesh, line. We're going to use a thick beam with an element length of 2. So I'm going to call this thick beam div equals 2. Okay, to assign it, I'm going to look end onto the model, box select these lines, and drag on the attributes. Okay, now the surface, I need a surface mesh. I'm going to use a thick shell, again with an element size of 2, and I'm going to call this thick shell div equals 2. Look end onto the model, select the surfaces, and I can drag on the surface mesh. Now the geometric properties of the rib I've already calculated using one of the arbitrary calculator tools. So I'm going to go to geometry, to geometry library, to use user sections, and this is the rib property that we're going to use. I'm going to look end onto the model, select the lines again, and I can drop on the rib section. And there you can see the deep rib. Now the slab is just a geometric surface thickness of 0.3. I'm going to call this thickness equals 0.3. Look end onto the model and select the surfaces and drag that on. So there's my model. Now at the moment, there's no physical connection between the ribs and the surfaces. So there's nothing connecting this point to this point. Now we're going to do that using a constraint equation. So constraint equation, tied mesh, and we're going to use a normal constraint. Now I'm going to use 4 of these. So I'm creating 4 of them, and that's because each rib is connected to the slab in 2 positions. Okay, so I'm going to select this line, drag on the constraint equation, and this will be the master constraint. I'm going to select this line in the slab, and this will be the slave. I now repeat this process using the 4 attributes across the model, using the master on the rib section and the slave on the slab section. So this is the last one, so master and then slave. So this will have now connected the rib section to the slab using a constraint equation. Okay, materials now. We're going to use a concrete section and we're going to use a EN1992-2 and a 40-50 mix. I'm going to select the lines for the rib, assign that, and then the surfaces for the slab and assign that. Okay, supports now. We're going to have 3 supports, so fixed X, Y, Z. This will be a pin support. We're going to free it in the X direction. So this is just fixed Y and Z. And this is going to be a guide support. And we're going to free it again in the Y direction. So it's just fixed in Z, and this will be a vertical support. I'm going to select this point here and assign the pin supports. And the other points along the rib, I'm selecting and I'm going to assign the guide support to those. Now this rib, I'm selecting all four points, and then I'm going to assign the vertical support to those. Okay, so there's my simple support conditions for this model. Okay, I'm going to go to the analysis tree view now, rename the load case to be dead load, and then I'm going to switch on the gravity option. This will apply gravity to the whole model in that particular load case. If I solve the model, you can see I've got a deformed shape. And if I switch on the window summary, I can see that I've got a sensible maximum deformation. Okay, now I actually want to see the composite bending moment on this. So I need to create some slice resultants. Now to do that, I'm going to create some groups first of all. So I'm selecting this part of the model. I'm going to create a group called right rib. I'm going to select this part of the model, create a group and call this left rib. And we're going to use these in the slicing facility. Okay, so I'm switching back on the slice lines and I'm going to select these three lines here and then go to utilities, slice results. These are the lines that I've selected. Now I'm going to slice along the lines at 3 meter increments, and the extent I'm going to choose right rib. And okay. I'm going to do the same. Select these lines on the left side. Slice resultants. Again, slice in 3 meter increments. But this time the extent is the left, so 3 meters here. Now what you'll see is red squares appearing on the model, and that's showing you the extent of the slices. I'm just going to load my results up. And now if I go to diagrams, I can look at diagrams of slice resultants, and I'm going to choose the component MY. And there you can see my slice resultant diagrams being displayed on the model. Now I'm just going to change the color the lines are drawn in. So I'm going to choose a black color. I just think it stands out better. So those are my slice resultants for the dead load case. Now that ends this part of the presentation. In the second part of the presentation, we're going to add in post-tensioning to this model.